Hello and welcome to another episode of Artist Profiles. I'm Beata Pieha. With me today is the industrial metal band Malfaktor. Thank you for joining us today.
Thank you.
Okay, so let's start by having you introduce yourself and tell us what you do in the band.
My name is Alex and I play guitar.
My name is Larry Orban and I play live bass and do computer programming.
My name is Rainzaifam. I do computer programming, sound engineering, and live keyboards.
My name is Doug Cheek. I lead sing and also do a little bit of programming.
Okay, cool. How did the band get started?
Back in 2005, out of the ruins of my former band, Ritualistic Suicide, myself, Larry, and former guitarist Tim Miller left that band and joined Malfaktor. We've basically been doing it ever since.
Cool. So what are your musical influences?
Well, we try to branch off and listen to a bunch of different things, but I personally mostly like darker industrial and fast electronic stuff like drum and bass.
Yeah, we're an industrial metal band, so we have the industrial side, but we also have the heavy metal side to it. You know, our influences range from anywhere from like Black Sabbath to, you know, Pantera, anywhere in between too. All the great bands, you know.
I see. I understand we have a clip of you guys performing, so let's take a look. Wow, that looks pretty intense. Do you feel your music has any special kind of message?
I think that it's just basically a throwback to the old industrial bands of like the early 80s, like Ministry, Skinny Puppy, even Kraftwerk. We're just trying to bring that back to the mainstream.
Nice. I understand you guys work a lot with the famous controversial underground filmmaker, the Iconoclaust, also known as Richard Lushbaugh, and his company Blind the Censors production. So how has that been like?
Oh, Richard's awesome. He does amazing photography and he's a pretty awesome guy.
Yeah, we all love Dick.
Are there any other underground artists you guys have worked with?
I've worked with a lot of different industrial bands. Mm-hmm. Dissector, Vicious Alliance, Regenerator, couple LA local bands, toured a lot, done like East Coast, West Coast, and industrial music just doesn't have a lot of the exposure mainstream music has, but there's a lot of good bands out there.
Mm-hmm. Nice. Who are some of the musicians that have done remixes of your songs for you?
Well, right now I'm currently awaiting on a remix from God Module. Dissector recently did one for me. Vicious Alliance is doing one for me. Tomegatherian, this really good power noise band, is doing one for me. You know, we're open to doing trades. I do remixes for other bands in turn, so we're just trying to release a remix album very soon.
Okay, so that's very interesting. Are there any bands you guys play shows with sometimes?
Well, we've been playing with No Last Resort, our former live keyboardist, Censors, Rebel's pretty awesome. It's an LA band.
Nice. And what are you guys currently working on?
We're working on a remix album, like we were talking about. And also, we're working on our new album, which both albums should be out in 2009.
Very cool. Where do you see the band Malfaktor going from here?
Well, right now I've been working with a lot of different booking agents and promoters trying to get our tour finished. Right now we're just doing LA shows to hold us over, but we will be hitting the East Coast and the West Coast soon. Pennsylvania is on the bill, Texas is on the bill. I did contact people from the Summer of Darkness Festival, so we might be getting in that one. WGT is a voting thing, so hopefully people vote us in this mm-hmm. year. But we're just trying to get our name out there, you know?
Yeah. That sounds great. I wish you all the luck, and it was great having you here today with us. And if you would like to find out more about the band Malfaktor, you can visit their MySpace page at myspace.com/Malfaktor. Thank you for joining us today on Artist Profiles. I'd like to thank our guests, Malfaktor. See you next time.